I just want to, just for edification, you know about the scripture, I'm going to bring it out for edification.
Hebrews 7:14, for it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
Right, so that's dealing with the Lord. I want to Acts 13, oh, actually. Sorry. But that's okay.
Acts,
you got Acts 13?
Acts 13 and 1.
Yep.
Now there were in the church that was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers.
Certain prophets and teachers.
As Barnabas and Simon.
Barnabas was one of Simon. Yeah.
That were called Niger.
Niger, nigga, means the same thing. It means black. It's a different variant. Negro. Some people say Negro in Spanish. Yeah. It's a different variation of the word. Not the root word, it just means black. It's a color.
Yeah.
Okay, because they were dark. And if you go to the mosaic, the earlier mosaics, and the pictures of the Christian churches, you see the disciples, they wore black. Even in Russia, you have what's called the Black Madonna.
Yes,
okay.
And Poland as well.
In Poland as well, too. I've worked with a few people from Poland. Now, this guy, all right, hold this. This guy right here was an actual person. I'm assuming you might not know. This was a guy who lived. All right, and you can do some research on this.
Yes, I don't know.
All right, we gonna show you. This is a man by the name of Caesar, and we got articles on it and everything. But you can do some research on it. His name is Cesar Borgia. They have a show. There's a Showtime that has it. They have a series called the Borgias family. Are you familiar with the Borgias family?
I've heard of that.
Okay, are you familiar with?
I haven't seen the series.
Are you familiar with? Okay. You're gonna give it right straight to you.
Okay.
Look at this guy. Does he not look just like this guy? Now, there was a book that was written called The Prince. You familiar with that book?
Machiavelli.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the book.
Terrible book.
Right. But he told this guy, Caesar Borgia, which was one of the sons of Pope Alexander.
Uh-huh.
Right? He told him, they basically put him up the Poles as the new Jesus. Now, why was that? Because, and what time was that, should I say?
That was in, like, the 1500s, 1600s.
The 14s going into the 15s. Okay. And what was that era called?
The Renaissance.
The Renaissance era, which Renaissance means what?
Rebirth.
The rebirth, good. Now, rebirth meaning what?
Well, I think you're driving at, they're trying to bring back the Roman Empire.
Okay, so, do you watch our videos?
No.
You never seen that?
I've never seen
you. Okay, good, but that's common sense. Rebirth of what? A lot of people didn't get that. They called it the Renaissance. If that was the first time of them ever coming to power, why would they name it the Renaissance? Because throughout history, they knew that one time they were in power, now they came back. And what they did was a thing called, are you familiar with an iconoclasm?
Yeah.
Which is what?
Iconoclasm?
Yeah.
Striking down of the icons.
Not necessarily striking them down, it's defacing them.
Ah, okay.
So
okay,
what they did was okay. All of the saints or whatever, the disciples and all the, any idols or icons of them, they either chipped their noses off, repainted some of them white, such as you had a Khazar priest doing right here. All right, whereas you had the picture of Jesus being a dark-skinned man, they painted up white. They went throughout as much as they could. There's so many relics, they couldn't cover all of them. That's why you still have some standing today. Now, let me ask you something. What is your nationality?
I'm afraid to even say. I consider myself Floridian more than anything.
Floridian?
Floridian.
From Florida?
I'm from Florida.
Okay, but now, what is your father?
He was from Florida, too.
And where was his father?
You go back far enough. I have a great-grandfather who came from a town called Pilsen, was now Czech Republic. At the time, it was Austro-Hungarian Empire. He didn't want to go die in World War I, so he hopped on a boat to America. Had two kids, and then this is something I recently learned, and it's very sad, but my great-grandmother could not afford a third child and sought to have an abortion and died.
Well, that was history.
So we don't know nothing.
That was history, but in that time, there was a lot of things going on.
Yes.
That wasn't right.
Yes.
And even more things happening in this time that ain't right.
But that's why I know my ancestry comes from.
Okay, well,
as far back as I can.
Good. Just straight. You answer me straight. Now, the Czech Republic, which, correct me if I'm wrong, at one point, wasn't that part of, the USSR?
Yeah.
Wasn't that part of it, that whole
yeah,
region?
Part of the Warsaw Pact.
Right.
Yeah.
So now if you go deeper, I don't know if I'm just gonna put, I gotta call both sides of it. So it goes deeper than skin color, all right? But you got so-called black men that look just like you. because it goes back to your ancestry. Now,
yes. The thing is, none of us can go all the way back.
Nobody has those records. A lot of those records have been destroyed.
Absolutely.
Some of them are in the Library of Congress. They're sealed and hid away.
Absolutely.
But the records that we do have, and give me Romans 8 and 16.
Romans 8 and 16.
All right, hold up. The records we do have is the Bible.
Yes.
So we do have the Bible. That's what that was left for us. Now, I'm just going to say this. I'm not saying it's definite, but it's a chance that you might be a so-called Negro. If you go back to your father. Because the Negroes ruled the whole Europe. The early czars of Russia were black people.
The fact of the matter is, people, we're never going to know all the records of where people have been on all over the face of this planet.
No, we are going to know. Because why? Prophecy. Okay, everything. The Lord said he was going to uncover everything that was covered up. Okay, that which you said it should be, that was done in the dark, should be brought to light.
Will be brought to light.
But now, which one you got? Romans?
Romans 8 and 16. The Spirit itself bear witness.
Right, the Spirit. What's the Spirit? The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit?
Yeah.
You ask me? That's a rough one. I don't want to misspeak and blaspheme against him.
Okay,
but I would say the Holy Spirit is the active principle of God working in us.
Not quite. John 6 and 63.
John 6 and 63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth.
It is the Spirit that quickeneth, but
the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you.
The what?
The words that I speak unto you.
The words that I speak unto you.
They are Spirit and they are life.
They are Spirit and are life. So what's the Spirit? The Word. The Word that the Lord spoke to us, which is what? The whole Bible. That's why he said, lo, I come in the volume of the book.
Uh-huh.
It is written of me. Because why? Going back from the Old Testament was prophesied of the Lord to come. And then in the New Testament is what? The disciples' account when the Lord was actually here.
Yeah.
So now, when it goes as far as the Spirit, I went there just to prove this to be politically correct according to the scriptures, or scripturally correct, should I say. According to the Bible, when it says the Spirit is what? Read that one more time.
John 6:63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are Spirit.
So the Spirit is the Word, the Holy Word. Now read this one more time.
Romans 8 and 16. Uh-huh. The Spirit itself bear witness with our spirit.
The Spirit itself bear witness with our spirit, meaning the Spirit, the Bible, the things that are written in the Bible, bear witness with what? Our spirit, but
that we are the children of the Most High.
That we are the children of the Most High. When you read in the Bible, who were the children of the Most High? The children of the Heavenly Father. Throughout the Bible, from Genesis to Revelations. It's easy.
Man, I could take that in a few ways.
It's easy. There's only one way that's going to be right, though.
I would, to tell you the truth, I would say the whole human race.
Yeah, but that's not, it doesn't say that in the Bible. We're talking about what the Bible says. Human race, that's a whole nother word.
The Israelites.
Exactly. The Israelites. Because that's something else, which I ain't going to go there yet. When you read in Genesis and Revelations, it always tell you about God's people, his chosen people, is the Israelites. So it says, read it again in Romans again.
Romans 8 and 16. The Spirit itself bear witness with our spirit.
Right, so the things in the Bible bear witness with our spirit. Meaning such as when you go into the prophecies about the Israelites were going to be brought by a slave ship, okay, into slavery.
Yes.
Right? And they were going to be sold on auctioning blocks. That's prophesied in the Lord, Deuteronomy. Okay, it's in Joel, in the book of the prophets. The Lord prophesied these things. When you do research certain history, which they're trying to get rid of, this history applies to what? So-called Negroes. But now you got to understand something. Not all the Negroes that came over here, they weren't Africans. That was a lie that was told. And our people were spread out throughout the whole world. So you got people that's why I said there's a chance you might be an Israelite if, in fact, your lineage goes back to a so-called Negro, which is an Israelite. But the way you're going to know now, because we don't have the records like they kept in the Bible. That's why they always ask you, you were known as your father's son.
Yes.
If your father's name was Joseph, it was Joseph's son, son of Joseph. Because that's how you were wrecked. That's how the genealogy were wrecked. When the so-called white man, when he came forth and established the international banking families. Are you familiar with the international banking families?
I'm all too familiar.
The Rothschild family?
Yeah. In fact, I saw a poster when you guys holding up a minute ago.
You see
the destiny of the white man being enslaved. I see it happening right now.
Exactly. Okay.
Like right now.
Yeah, right. Hey, he's speaking.
I can hear it right now.
He's speaking the truth on that one.
Look, you go out and buy a car. You go out and go to the bank. You know what they're going to want to see? They're going to see the car, so if you don't pay, they take the car away. You buy a house, not the house is collateral. What is the collateral when a nation goes into debt?
The people.
That's right.
The people.
That's absolutely right.
And the proof of it is what? The so-called birth certificate.
Yes.
The social security number that you have means that you're property of the government.
Yeah.
What do you think they're gonna do with this RFID chip? That's already mandated.
They're already doing it.
Right.
It's gonna be in every damn everything you buy.
Are you gonna accept
it? And ultimately, they're gonna put a chip either under here, maybe back here, with the skin's all
right,
fat.
Right. They want to put it in your skin.
The skin's all loose.
They put it in the back of your neck. Are you gonna accept it?
No.
Okay. Good. Good. Well. Hey,
I've known that for a long time.
Hey, well, that's good. That's. But, I don't know if he's Esau. He might be an actual Israelite.
But the thing is, you know, it's like I go, like, I mean, I don't know. Like, I see a country that I live in.
But this is not a country. America's really not a country. If you really go deep,
that's
into
what
it.
People will tell me the most. People. People don't like to hear what I have to say about America.
Yeah, facts are facts, though. Truth is truth.
Yeah, well, that's how it is.
America is a corporation.
That's how it is. It's been ran like a long time ago.
Yeah.
Like a long time ago. I was a little kid, okay? I was already reading the Bible, and I saw, I think it was Bush the First.
Okay.
Okay, King Bush the First. During his inauguration. And he goes up, you know, and he puts his hand on the Bible. He swears his oath to uphold the Constitution. And I remember, because I read Sunday school, maybe 2 weeks before. But the Bible says, Jesus himself, in fact, says, that do not swear by the hairs on your own head. And here we are in this Christian nation,
right,
swearing an oath on a book that tells us how to swear oaths.
So what does that show?
That there is no limit to the blasphemy of this thing of Ephesians.
Right.
No bottom to it. And these oaths, they keep the oaths.
That's because the white man is the devil. That's what the devil does. The devil does. He breaks God's laws, but he acts like he's a Christian.
Yeah.
You know?
Absolutely.
In order
to make all the other people sit on the fence, think of the Lord and the Lord's way in terms of what they're doing.
That's how they took over what's called the United States of America. They did it to the Native American Indians.
Yes.
All right? They befriended them and everything.
Yes.
And they set them up.
Got their help.
And then once they seen the opportunity,
yep,
they took that to make sure the knife was sharp. Right in the back.
And then the thing that really blows my mind, I got a couple friends who have fallen into the trap of nationalism, uber nationalism. America is their God. And I was talking to one of my friends, trying to get him to see just a little bit of the truth. And what he told me,
It's not, truth is not for everybody, my friend. All right?
No.
First of all, hey, people that trust in America, that's all right. We're not out here trying to save nobody. We're just teaching this word, and it's only for the elect. Whoever understands this word, and if their spirit understands this word, we that's good. Everybody else, we don't care about. We don't care about nobody. We're only about the elect, and we understand that the majority of our people, they're gonna die. Two thirds of them are gonna die. All so-called white people, they're gonna die here in America. All other nations that's outside, that's not an Israelite, they're gonna die here. The ones that are Israelites that might not have known it or whatever, that's where the parable of the wheat and the tares come into play. Right? And then what did the Lord say? He said, let the wheat grow with the tares till the end, to the last days. The Lord is gonna separate, and even you got some people that look like our people, but they're not, all right? But
now, do you have anything I can take to read?
We got, you know what? Karan, write them.
Or a web address.
We got a few websites.
I want to learn more, but I got to pick somebody up. I promise you.
We got a bunch of websites. He's going to give you one or two, and everything else will pop up.
Thank you.
And if you watch our website, you're going to learn. This is what we do.
I certainly hope to.
Okay. And like I said, I can't front. Maybe you a devil, a so-called white man. Maybe you're